ויקח אוהבת עשרו גמלים מגמלי אדוי נוף. רשי says, ניקורין הויו. These גמלים are the famous אברהם's גמלים, שהויו יויצים זמומים מפני הגזל. They were muzzled, protecting somebody else's properties. Later, ויפתח הגמלים, רשי says, היתיר זומם שלהם. He opened up, שהויו סוסם, espihem shelo yiru baderech besodos acherim. Avraham was protecting his gemalim from stealing. The Ramban asks Akasha. We find by Rav Pinchas ben Yoir that his animal was nizhar even to eat from demai. Avraham's animals were not sensitive to being oivan aveiro. And Pinchas ben Yoir's animals were much of a high madrege? What's the story by Pinchas ben Yoir? He had a chamor, the Medrash brings down, Rav Pinchas ben Yoir was in a inn by his Talmidim. Ganovim came and they stole that chamor and they brought it to their Me'ara cave. The chamor did not want to eat and drink for 3 days straight. The Ganovim were scared that this chamor is going to die and the Nevela is going to reveal their position. So they decided to return the chamor. The hungry and thirsty chamor was giving to eat Seorim, but it would refuse the food. So Rav Pinchas ben Yoir asked his Talmidim, maybe you were not nizhar in trumos for the Koyanim and masros for the Leviim. Anything that grows in Eretz Yisrael has to be given trumos and masros. Maybe that's why my chamor is refusing from eating this food. The Talmidim says, chas v'sholom. We are never nichshal in trumos and masros. So Rav Pinchas ben Yoir asked, maybe this is demai. Maybe you bought from Am Ha'oretz that the Rabbonon is easier to eat from food from an Amoretz because he might not give Trumos and Maestres. Even though Rav Ame Ha'oretz are Me'asrim, but a miyut of the Ame Ha'oretz are not Me'asrim, and that's why the Rabbonon there is easier to eat. An Amoretz is somebody who does not wear tefillin the whole day. The Gemara says, Mesechte Brochus Daf Nun Zayin. In the times of Chazal, if you bought food from Am Ha'oretz, you have to give Maestres again. And the Talmidim said, Rebbe, didn't you teach us that for a behemoth you are allowed to give demai? In other words, the whole Isser is only for people, not for behemoths. Rav Pinchas ben Yoir says, it could be. But it seems that my chamor is machmir, and probably it detected that this particular Am Ha'oretz was not me'aser. Now the loch is, if you ask the Am Ha'oretz whether he was me'aser or not, depends. In the weekdays, he is not believed. On Shabbos, he's believed. Why? Amos or the Shabbos Olov. Say Yerushalmi. Shabbos, Anamores has Amo. He's scared to say a lie. So they were mafrish, trumos, and maestros on the demai. And the chamor of Pinchas ben Yoir ate. And the Gemara and Mesech Techulin, in the beginning of Zayin Omed Beis, makes a kal v'choymer. Im behemtum shel tzadikim, en hakodosh baruch hu mevi takol al yodom, Tzadikim al atzmon al achas kama v'kama. The Ramban has a kasha. How can we say that Avraham Avinu had to tie up the mouth of his animals that should not be nirchshal on gezel, and Rav Pinchas ben Yoir didn't have to worry about his chamor? His chamor will not even eat the mai. And the Medrash Taka says that the chamor of Pinchas ben Yoir was bigger than the gemalim of Avraham Avinu. But from the Gemara, it's not mashma like that. The Gemara doesn't say that the chamor of Pinchas ben Yoir was bigger than the gemalim from Avraham Avinu. We have to understand what is the difference between this chamor and this gemalim. And Rabbi Chonim Vassam wants to make an afkimina between gezel and macholos asuros. The Gemara in Shabbos, Daf Yud Beis Omed Beis, speaks about the story of Rabbi Yishmoel ben Elisha Kohen Godol. He once was over on the Dakonus Chazal, Ein koirin b'shabbos le'oir haner, shema yate, might put up the light, v'kora v'hito, and he was nichshol. On Rav Noson, he wrote b'pinkusoy, l'keshibone b'is hamigdosh, ovi chatos shmeino. He's going to bring a korban chatos. B'shoigig, he was mate the ner on Shabbos. Toises as a kasher. Why don't we say the kal v'choymer of Pinchas ben Yoir? Uma behemtom shel tzadikim. אין הקדוש ברוך הוא מביא את הכל על יודום, צדיקים על עצמו נלך אז כמה וכמה. And Toises wants to say, there is a difference between מידי דה חילו אין חילו שבס. This haftochot that a tzaddik is not going to be nichshol is davke in midi de achilo, as the Chamorov Pinchas ben Yoir. But we never find that tzaddikim have an haftochot that they're not going to be nichshol on any other aveira. For example, Tosfos brings down the Gemara in Yevamos, daf tzaddik, vov medbeis. In Tverio, there was a beis medrash, and there was a machloikes rabbonim, whether you allow to be metaltel a certain doorknob, whether it's mukzi or not, since you can use it to prepare food. Who were these chachomim? Rabbi Loz and Rabbi Yose. In the middle of the machloikes, they tore Esef et Toiro. Rabbi Yose ben Kismin was there, and he said, I am afraid if this Beis HaMedrash is not going to turn into a Beis HaBoido Zoro. Vekachav. So you see, Toiso says, there is no haftocho that a person should be nichshol in tearing a sefer Torah. And Tosfos brings a third raya from a Gemara Masechta Makos by Rabbi Yehuda ben Tabbai that he killed an eight zoimim kedei lehoitzi milibon shel haminim. The Torah says, ve'osiso kashezomom lasos le'ochiv. If a set of eidim says, Reuven killed Shimon, a second set says, how can you say Reuven killed Shimon when you were that day with us in a different place? You killed the set of Edom. What happened if the Edom came too late after Reuven was killed? Then you cannot kill anymore the Edom, even though they are Zoimimim, because the Torah says, also. That's the Shitas Chazal. But the meaning is to say just the opposite. You only kill the set of Edom Zoimimim only after the person was killed. There's another din that you're not allowed to kill the eight zoimim unless you mazim both eidim, the whole cut, the whole set. And Rabbi Yehuda ben Tabbai went and he killed one eight zoimim kedei lehoitzi milibum shel minim. The Gemara says he was choite because you're not allowed to kill one eight. And he was mekabel on himself not to be moire hoiro shelo bifnei raboi. Every day he used to go to the Beis HaKvoros and be mispadel and to cry, ask for mechilo for this eid that he killed. So Tosfos says, you see from here that there isn't such a haftocho that a person should not be nichshol in different averos, only in mili de achilo. There's another question. The Rashba says, the Gemara in Chulin brings down about the tarnegoilo de agmo, that they thought it is not doires, and the chachomim were matted to it, and people ate. Afterwards they found that it was doires, and they gave an iser to eat tarnegolto de agmo. To the Rashba Azakashi, that's a mili de achilo. You see, a person can be nichshol mili de achilo. So what do you do with this Tosfos and Shabbos, Tavid Beis and Medbeis? So the Rashba answers, al koch, you have to say that the chachomim themselves did not eat this tarnegolto de agmo, but they were nichshol on difne iver lo sit nichshol, that somebody else ate it. But they themselves have a haftocho, en a kodosh borcho, maybe takolo, b'mili d'achilo, kal v'choyme von chamore shel Pinchas ben Yoir. So Rabbi Chonah Wasserman wants to say, the same thing is with gezel. Gezel is not midi d'achilo. This food is muter for one person, and it's also for the person who doesn't own the food. So there is no haftocho. And according to Rabbi Chonah Wasserman, it's very possible that Rabbi Pinchas ben Yoir himself used to muzzle his chamor should not eat gezel, because the chamor is nizar on mili de achilo, not on mili de gezel. Memeilo Avraham Avinu also, he was not nichshol on mili de achilo, but he could have been nichshol on mili de gezel. This is Rabbi Chonah Wasserman's mehalach. But not everybody holds like that. Many people hold that achila shel gezel is achila shel iser. And that's the shittas of Medrash, that the chamor of Pinchas ben Yoir was bigger than the gemalim from Avraham Avinu. So you see, the Medrash hold that gezel is called midi de achila. So we have to say a different teretz. Rabbi Chaim Kanievsky wants to say that the behemoth of Avraham Avinu did not eat from a gezel. The chamor of Pinchas ben Yoir did not eat from the gezel. And it's Shaykh that gezel is taki midi de achilo. So you have to say the reason why did Avraham Avinu cover the mouth of his behemoth, of this gemalim? So people should learn from it. He should be nizar of gezel, but he himself was protected from achilo shel gezel. Or you can say a different teretz. Perhaps Shema Yigrom Hachet, like the Gemara says about Yaakov Avinu. So Avraham Avinu covered the mouth of the Gemalim because he did not trust his tzidkus. We can say b'derech remez, kol ha'noitel pruto mechaveiro ki'ilo noitel es nafshoi. If somebody steals from somebody else's properties, it's like he takes away his nefesh. Mido keneged mido, Eliezer was poisoned, but he was nitzel from poison because his gemalim, migmale adoinov, did not eat from somebody else's property. Kol ha'nizer gezel, shoy meres nafshoi.